Good morning students, square and square roots. In my last video I told you that how we can find out whether a given number is a perfect square or not by the method of prime factorization method. Now in this video I will be telling you that how we can make a number as a perfect square by multiplication and the division of the smallest required number. Let us take an example of 180. This 180 will find out the factors by prime factorization method. Dividing by 2 we will get 90. Again dividing by 2 we will get 45. If you find out difficulty in dividing, you can just have the rough work to find out the division. 2 9s are 18. 10, 90, 10. So in this way you can solve in the rough to find out the division. Again this 45 is divisible by 3 15 times. 15 is divisible by 3 using the divisibility rule for 3 and 2, which you have read in class 6th. You can just recall them. 5 and then dividing by 5. Now 180, this is written in terms of the product of its prime factor. 2 into 2 into 3 into 3 into 5. Now we pair up the common factors, 2 into 2 and 3 into 3. 5 is left over. Now if we multiply it by 5, then we have to multiply here also by 5. Then the factors of 180 into 5 will be in the pair. 2 into 2 is in pair, factor of 3 is also in pair, and 5 is also becoming in pair. So 180 into 5 is giving this as the product of its factor in pair. And 180 into 5 you can find out in rough as 900. 18 5 is 90 and is 0. So 900 is that number which is a perfect square, and then we can find out the square root of this number. Square root of 900 will then be 2 into 2 into 5, taking out the common from each factor like this. 2 is taken common here, here is 3. So 3 is taken common and 5 from here. So square root of 900 is 30. Now to find out that what smallest number should be multiplied is, the smallest number that should be multiplied is the 5, the number which is left over, whose pair is not there. It may be one factor or two factors. Now another example where we have to find out that by what number we should be divide so that the number becomes a perfect square. Let us take an example of 396. So dividing it by 2 to find out the prime factors, we'll getting 198. Again dividing by 2, we will be getting 2 9s are 18 and 2 9s are 18. Now 99 is divisible by 3 as 30 3 times. Again dividing by 3, we will be getting 11, then 11 1 time. Now 396 is written in terms of its product of factors as 2 into 2 into 3 into 3 into 11. Now pairing up the common factors, 2 is there, 3 is there, and 11 is left over there. So if we divide this number 396 by 11, then it must be a perfect square. So we just divide 396 by 11, and on division we will be getting 36, and we know that 36 is a square of 6. So we get that 36 is a perfect square number. 396 is not a perfect square. Finding its factors by prime factorization method, pairing up, 11 is left over. Whatever is left over factor, the same you have to divide to this number so that we can get a perfect square. And square root of 36 is 6. 2 into 3, that is 6. So you just try the exercise question by yourself and find out the smallest number which should be multiplied or divided to make a number as perfect square.